Today I'm building the second modular building for the Lego City. The goal is to integrate it into this mills plate where I made this road earlier. And I'm not sure if it'll work because I'm not seeing enough space here. There's only 4 studs in the back. But then over here, there is some stuff that could be removed. But if it doesn't work, then I'll just build a new mills plate. Looks like the build is broken up into 4 parts and 3 separate instruction books. So looking at this, there's 4 studs, and I think if I just start building here, it should work out. I think some of these tiles and other pieces can be swapped out to different colors to have it all blend in, but for now we're on the right track to get it all to fit on the same plate. It looks like the designer made a fun Easter egg where you build out the letters in tiles, and I believe we'll probably just build right over all of that. Instead of these Technic pieces, I'm just gonna put in a 1x2 light bluish gray brick instead. I didn't have to remove anything from the road, and the foundation fits in just right. So the plan worked out perfectly. Tiny tile work is definitely one of my least favorite things to do, but I know it looks really good when it's all done. So I think this is supposed to resemble a fire, but it is really, really difficult to put in. The kitchen is coming together, but I'm not sure how I feel about these pastries being right by the sink. Feels like a food safety violation. This whole time I've been wondering what's gonna go in this space, and we get this island. So here's the first bag, and I have to say that I am really liking how this looks. I think I made the right choice in leaving the road in, and my only complaint would be the same that I feel about most modulars, is that they're too cramped. And I think that if I didn't have the road in, I could have expanded the restaurant out further. But at the end of the day, I like how it all looks, and I'm pretty satisfied. And if this building ends up having a front-facing view for the city, then I can see how it would make sense to remove all of these bricks and put in masonry ones instead. Sorting through all the pieces for this bag, and I'm getting a little worried about this restaurant because there's a rodent in it. I'm curious where they place it because this will not fly in lost credits. Okay, so this was not a fire. It is actually cheese because now we're putting in the front door for the fridge. I gave our minifigs seating outside. Mrs. Credits is happily enjoying her croissant. And then I really love how this bar turned out. It's built directly into the wall, which was really interesting. I would have figured it would have been into the ground, but yeah, it looks kind of a nice mixture of simple, but some ornate. Adding windows and the door. As someone who builds a lot of Star Wars sets, this reminds me of something that would go in a microfighter. So I'm really curious to see how they use it here. So that piece was used to make these columns, which will then go right over here. Getting to the point where the build feels a little fragile, and I think it's because the windows and columns don't interlock, but then when you add in these bricks, it works out okay, and I assume as we continue, it'll be more stable. We've got this really nice tile piece with the menu. This whole time I've been wondering why we only have one gate piece, and it's for this awning here. With the third bag, you start with the outside patio, and I was surprised that it's built as a separate modular entity, but it makes sense from a stability standpoint. Like the interior, it's a cozy space, but it does work, and I love the arms being used to hang the flower pots. Next, you build this room where I assume the chef stays, and there is a lot of detail packed in here, like this chair that swivels and the Murphy bed. The flowers here are a nice touch, but you actually have to place them at the right angle so the window can slot in. And finally, there is a balcony and a staircase that go up to the studio space on the next floor that you build in the final bag. The studio is a great way to cap the set. It comes with some painting accessories and this furnace build, but the highlight is definitely the roof design. It is a bit finicky to put in, but once complete, it looks fantastic. And before finishing the build, I did go back and add the masonry bricks in. Thinking back on the build, I know I initially said that I wasn't a fan of how cramped it all felt, but having completed it, I'm really quite chuffed with how it turned out. And I would even go as far as saying that story-wise, it's a very popular restaurant with limited seating and a very long waiting list. When I built the bookshop, my first modular, there were several interior design changes that I thought of making immediately. However, for the Parisian restaurant, outside of the exterior design changes that I made by integrating my road into the build, I don't plan on changing anything. Even the olive green color, which I did not love at all at first, I've grown quite fond of it, and I think it works perfectly.
She is magnificent.
Vindication!
Some of my favorite elements of this build include the way the sign is hung up, the Murphy bed in the apartment above, the design for the banister and the way it's placed in, and the entire roof design was so much fun to build. The only part of the build that I didn't truly love was the use of the pesky white croissants for the roof because of how easily they fall off. It was definitely nice parts usage, but this was so frustrating to put together. This is only my second modular, so time will tell, but at this very moment, it feels like it would take a lot to top this set in terms of the build experience.
I feel like I'm floating on a croissant.
I know that progress in the city has been virtually non-existent. It has been so slow, but now that the room is finally coming together and I actually have space to display things, I'm hoping to put more buildings together and actually put the city together and put it on display. And on that note, if you enjoyed this video and want to see the city develop some more, hit the subscribe button. My goal is to surpass 1,000 sometime in 2024. And I think the next building I put in will be the boutique hotel, but let me know in the comments if you want to see something else. And as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Oh yeah, and the mouse, it stays outside, so it's all good.